If you're pregnant or thinking about pregnancy, you can choose to have prenatal genetic testing. These tests tell you whether your pregnancy has or will likely have a genetic disorder. There are two categories of prenatal genetic tests: screening tests and diagnostic tests. Screening tests tell you the chances your pregnancy may have or not have a genetic disorder. Diagnostic tests tell you whether your pregnancy may actually have a genetic disorder. First, let's talk about common screening tests. Anytime before or during pregnancy, you can have a test called carrier screening. This test tells you whether you carry a gene for certain genetic disorders that you might pass to your child. Both parents may be tested. Other types of screening tests can be done only during pregnancy. These include blood tests and ultrasound exams. These screening tests can show if there are signs of Down syndrome or other genetic disorders. One type of blood test is called serum screening. Different types of this test may be done in the first trimester, second trimester, or both in the first and second trimesters. Serum screening measures the levels of certain proteins in your blood. If the levels are higher or lower than normal, it may be a sign of a genetic disorder. Another type of blood test is called cell-free DNA screening, also called noninvasive prenatal testing, or NIPT. Some of the DNA from your pregnancy can be found in your blood. Cell-free DNA screening tests for that DNA in your blood. This screening can show the chances that your pregnancy has certain types of genetic disorders. Cell-free DNA screening can be done anytime after 9 or 10 weeks of pregnancy. Remember, screening tests show only the chances your pregnancy has a genetic disorder. A diagnostic test can show if your pregnancy actually has the disorder. In diagnostic tests, cells are taken from the placenta or the amniotic fluid surrounding the fetus. These cells contain the same genetic material as the fetus. The cells are collected with a tube or needle and are sent to a lab for testing. There are two types of these tests: chorionic villus sampling, CVS, and amniocentesis. CVS can be done earlier in pregnancy than amniocentesis. Both tests come with a small risk of miscarriage. There is a slightly higher risk of miscarriage with CVS than amniocentesis. In most cases, diagnostic test results come back normal. If your test result shows your pregnancy has a genetic disorder, you can talk with your OBGYN or genetic counselor about what the results mean for your pregnancy. Remember, it's your choice whether to have prenatal testing. Before deciding, you can talk about all your options with your OBGYN.